Hello, welcome. Today we're going to do a quick Calisto guide for any pure, any low level. This is the setup we've got. So you want a dark bow or you want a long bow and you want some rune arrows. The dark bow is for your special attack, so you can add 2 or 3 specials while attacking Calisto. You want 2 range potions. You're only going to use 1. This is set up so we can do at least 2 packs a trip. We can probably get 3 packs out of it, but it's only safe to do 2. You want 2 anti-poisons for the spiders up there. If you haven't got high prey, we've only got level 4 prey, so you want an anglerfish so we can boost our health. And then we just want to eat swordfish. This is the setup. We want as much range damage as we can because Calisto's got 230 range. So we've got a Robin Hood hat. You could also have a coif. A Robin and coif ain't too much difference, but it will make a difference when Calisto's 230 defense in range. Got your leather body and your black chap set and your black band set. Got a rune crossbow. The dragon crossbow's fine. The Mardi crossbow's fine. They're all great great alternatives. So is the Dragon Hunter crossbow. Dragon Hunter crossbow is probably the better one out of the lot. However, a rune crossbow will suffice as well. You're going to want the Book of Lore. You're going to want to put a Book of Lore on to boost your range even more. And then you're going to want anything from an Amulet of Power for your defense bonus, all the way up to a Fury or the torture or whatnot, or even an anguish. An anguish would be perfect. However, because we're going into deep worldy, we don't want to risk too much. I'm risking the Robin Hood hat, which could be swapped for an anguish. And we also are risking our bolts are a risk, which is about 100k. Keep it at 400 so you can get 2 kills. 200 ruby bolts is absolutely fine. Got the Ring of Dueling, so you can come back to the PvP area. Ferox Enclave, you definitely want to get back to here as fast as possible. And Auxiliary is really unique as well, because we can teleport out at 30 worldy rather than using the maze teleporters in the wilderness, which is fine. That's our setup. We're going to quickly look at our difference in range. So we've got 148 range, so we're only 90, 82 range down. And then when we've got our spec out, we've got 143 range, so it's like 95 down. So we do hit relatively often for our account, which is good news as well. These are our stats. I really wouldn't recommend anything less than 80 to start Calisto. If you're 80, you're gonna have to pot. Realistically, you ain't hitting much unless you're 89 or plus. So when we pop, we're going to be 92, and we're going to let it go down to 89, depending on the situation. And we plan to have 1 range pop per encounter, hence why we've got 2. Like I said, if you have 4 prayer, the normal tactic for Calisto, sorry, I am quite old today, just pray for some peace and some mental well-being and some health. If you are down at Calisto with 4 prayer, normally you've got to be have mage down there. Calisto bangs about 60. You can combo me out, you can kill me. I might die trying to set up this lore. But that's the basic. My combat level's level 60. And the average person told you to take a longbow. They normally say magic longbow. The dark bow is by far the better alternative, so we can get 3 specs into our rotation at Calisto. So once you've got a setup looking like this, you can bring better food if you're worried about getting PvP'd. However, the first thing we're going to do as a level 60 is switch world. I've been PvP'd. I've only got about 8 or 9 kills. I've been killed in PvP like 5 times doing Calisto. Lost myself just under 1 million altogether at least 5 times with bolts. So the first thing we want to do is we want to get a world total. I want to go to the 250, we're going to be really, really mappist, and we're going to go to the other 250 world just for ping, just for server quality, and because I am from Britain, so we're going to go to the British server. And you want to get down here out of Fox Cove, Sea Rock Cove even. Let me read that correctly, make sure it's a brand new content. As far as I'm aware, I've only came back for the past, I've been back for about 10 days, 14 days, maybe 18 days. I haven't done much apart from brought my stats back up. I did have 77 range, I did have 77 magic, I haven't touched my strength or attack. I also had like 40 or 50 slayer, so we went and got a slayer up. We got 5 crafting levels, 2 fletching levels, 1 wood cutting level. We got 5 fire making levels. We got 15 cooking levels. We got a little, I think we got 2 fishing levels. We got 2 smithing levels. We got 9 mining levels. We haven't got any agility levels. The thing with agility is being level 4. And let me just make my character. Everybody knows this game's such a patient game and such a delicate game that we need to make the character look absolute on point while it's standing there. With the agility, with my account only being 4 player, I can get the 5% strength boost, which only boosts my max hit by 1, so prayer is not too much of an issue. And normally if I do go PvP, if I'm praying, I'll put thick skin on and I'll make sure I've got a bit more defense. I got no herb lore levels, but I've done a bit of herb loring for a bit of money. I've also went and got myself 18 runecrafting levels, and because Gilded Leah, I managed to go around and get 50 construction levels as well, because they were doing construction, and I've got myself 1 hunting level. I was big into hunting. To make my money for the account, I started out with going down to the Black Chins. I went down to the Black Chins with a moon crossbow and some broad bolts. That's it. With a few manta rays, a few karam bombs, made sure they were both blighted. I also went down with a teleblock, that's what the 85 mage is for, and I went down with an entangle just so we could stop them from getting to level 30 wilderness and teleporting out. In total, I've made about 10 million just at Black Chin since I've been back in the 18 days, and I haven't been there every other day. I haven't even been there quite a lot, but let's say for the past 4 or 5 days, I went down to the Black Chin, made about 10 million. I only spent about an hour and a half there each day. So if you are struggling to make a bit of money, take a rune crossbow. Go down to the chin area and just wait in your world, and hopefully these people just hop in like sections of 4 or 5 at a time, just one bang them all. Anyone that runs off, teleblock them or entangle them first is what I found, so they can't move, then teleblock them, then attack them. But most of the time you can just entangle them and attack them 3-4 times before the tangle's over. They're normally dead because they will normally take 4 lobsters. I am very into the wilderness, very PvP orientated. I do like the danger that it gives me out in the wilderness, and the different interactions to the game being in the wilderness compared to the regular places. I have been an ultimate Iron Man, I have had an Iron Man, I've played a regular account with defense, but I do mainly like to play pures. I also had a skiller, I've removed them all, I don't keep them all, this is the main account at the moment. This will be the main account for the further future. This account itself is 14 years and 7 months old, so it's a pretty old account. It's got nice builds, we're not going to ruin it. There's a few disadvantages to this thing, like the prayer. Like if I've got 4 prayer, I can't go and do Priest in Peril to do that quest. Stops me doing a few things. The main ones are Desert Treasure. Can't do Desert Treasure on this account. It also means Jad becomes a little bit harder, which means I'm going to have to do Jad with a little suffering and a bit more money, but it will eventually get done. I don't feel too confident in doing that because it's something I've never done without prayer. And there is a recipe of disaster. Downside, there is a few quests that require priest in peril in the recipe of disaster. I've not quested at all. My quest log is pretty small. My quest log's tiny. Completed quest, as you can see, only 25 points. What I did while I was completing quests, and the good thing about this account is I can complete all the quests that I need and all the remaining quests that I can do, and I won't go up a single level, not at the moment. And we're trying to stay 60. I don't think that's gonna happen. I think we might go up to the level 70 bracket. At the moment, level 60 is perfect, because if I do need that extra bit of money, I can go down to Black Chins. However, I feel my wealth is over 5 million, so we've protected our bond, which is the main concept. Make sure you can get 5 million to protect a bond. Once you've protected your bond, anything over, you can spend on cosmetics like the gnome scarf. The gnome scarf, one of my favourite neck items. So is the Robin Hood hat. I do like the Arcidius hoods at the moment, especially the green and the red, the green and the brown one. There's a lot I do like about this game. I've played it for a long time. I've never streamed. I've never done YouTube. I've never been part of it. I've never even made a video. I haven't made a video at all. I've got a lot of love for them people that want to sit there and say I'm a liar. We'll play it down as a circle, because I believe no one's been down to the circle before. I am a member of the square. And there was something about triangles, but I'm not quite sure. That's from other people, and that's other people's knowledge. We do have that knowledge about, we do have that wisdom about. But let's get into it. And also, the last thing that I did level up as well was this farming. Farming was level 1, construction was level 1 when I logged in 18 days ago. And we got the farming from doing the garden while doing construction to get our early construction levels, where you put maximum garden round, went and filled it all. Quite expensive, it's about 10,000 a plant, but we went through it all. The way we got our first bit of money, there's nothing wrong with doing it. I can't stress this enough. If you start a new account and you're willing to buy membership, you might as well pay the $9.99 for your very first time, just for your very first time. This is simply so you can get 2 months, or you can get a month worth of membership, 28 days, and you get a spare bond. I wouldn't buy membership straight up unless you buy the VIP and the gold membership, or the premium membership, or however they want to label it, but we all know what we're on about. I would say to you, pay $9.99, buy 3 bonds, save 2 bonds, use 1 bond for the membership. Put the other bond in your pouch or your bank, keep that away, so once your membership runs out, you don't have to worry about protecting your bond for the first 14 days, so you can get back into the game. And you also have 1 bond that you can sell for 5 million. That 5 million will get you your starter gear. That 5 million will get you your starter skills. That 5 million will get you your starter stats. Personally, I played this game for so long. I'm a 15 year plus player. This account's 14.7 years. And when it comes down to it, there's time, which the game does well. This game will reward you for its time in a real scale. This is the only game I've ever found, just the RuneScape franchise, the game that I've, and they've got 2 games just like it, which is brilliant. I'm not saying it's better than anything else, I'm not saying it's worse than anything else, but I've played 250 MMORPGs, and out of all of them, this is the best. For my entertainment, this is the best for my reward system. Like, if you want to reward yourself in a real time, I've played other games. These other games have gave me a challenge, like you've only got a month, and then a month your max level, and then the end game is there. I've played this for 30 days straight. This is where my account lies. This is where we're going to take our account from. Luckily for you lot, the first video is Calisto. I feel like you have to get to know me a little bit. I feel like I have to talk a little bit about the game and why I like it. And as you can see here, I have the standard max end game time for any MMORPG. Any MMORPG that you go to, they say 30 days is enough. 30 days, a whole month is enough to reach yourself end game. Maybe 31 days, but after 30 or 31 days of playing any other MMORPG, you should be at endgame. I am nowhere near endgame, but we are going to go do some endgame content. I'm only level 60. Level 60 combat. That's it. And there is a multiple selection of professions for them people that want to come from other MMORPGs. I am an enthusiast about this game. This is the only game I've played that doesn't seem realm locked either. You can log into this game. You can make this game. You can make yourself an account on this game anonymously. And when you make yourself an account on this game anonymously, you can still play with your friends no matter what. No matter what, don't matter what world you start on, don't matter whereabouts you start, don't matter what you do, you can always go and meet your friend on this game. The other thing is, this game has never seen less than 34,000 people online at any one time. Since like 2004, there has not been anyone less than 34,000. Basically, once it made 34,000, it stayed at that, and as it expanded, there's like 250,000 active players and there's 34,000 people on at any one time. So the world is quite packed. The world's huge, the world's enormous, the world's massive, the world's absolute massive. I ain't gonna sit here and give tips for new players too much, but we'll get to that after we've gone and done the Calisto run. I will talk about tips, I will talk about an opinion, I will talk about strategy and stuff that could help you save time. But when it comes down to a game, this is the only MMORPG that rewards you for your time in a actual real rewarding sense. I've never played a game that's required so much of my time, so much of my patience, and for me to sit down and do a lot of tasks that I don't want to go and start until I've started it. This game spends a lot of time doing social. This game spends a lot of time standing around and trying to tell yourself not to do a task, because when you get started on a task, especially at the later games and the later levels, let's say mid game, we're probably about mid game here, I could say that safely. I could say it's still quite early game because of my pure and I'm still pretty young on my level. I'm only level 60 combat. The combat, the level goes from level 3. You don't start at level 1, you start at a level 3 and you get to 126 combat, and you've got to go and get yourself 99 in various stats. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's 7 combat stats and the rest are professions, and there's roughly 22 to 25. I haven't counted, I can't remember, but it's all there. You can see all them, they are professions, they are combat skills. And they are actually called skills in this game, not professions. But if you want a game where you can go around and trade, this game is money incorporation game. This game is strictly based on the economy and how much money you can spend. And I've never played a game that's gave me so much more for my time and so much rewards for actually spending time in a single character. And it's a good game to play, for example, if you want to video edit and you've got a desktop PC, you can play the game on one screen, you can sit there and level up, and for example, you could woodcut for about 4 or 5 months or even 2 months, or woodcut for 2 months, and in that 2 months you could edit your videos, in that 2 months you can watch some television, in that 2 months you can do other things. Let's just quickly say hi, see what's up. He could be on my friends list. It's not on my friends list. Let's say Iro. Question mark. This could be my friend. I saw a level 60 Sibo and Rangers. Let me just turn my chat on. And Rangers tuna EDC. You want to debo him? No, thank you. Going Calisto. Thank you for invite. He's free to email, just saying. People do come up to me as a target. I can't hit him. Oh man. Just tell him to have a good day, because he will be able to hear that as he's ran off. Although I can't see a small dot on the map. Can't see him, can't see where he's gone. That's another player. I'm in a pretty secluded place. I'm in a pretty low level world. In fact, let's see how many people we've got. I'm in a world with only 165 people. and I still got into a conversation and I still got invited out to go and fight someone else, and this person's used his own eyes while scouring the whole of the world, and he's seen where another level 60 is, and he said, are you the guy, are you the hitman, are you the mandem, are you the gang, are you the people that want to go around and give him the bang and send him back down to Lumbridge Swamp? And I'm not today because I'm bossing. So let me quickly look through this world feature with you. In the middle you can see how many people, on the right you can see what the world's for, on the left you can see the world number, and in the middle again on the left you can see the flag for what nationality that realm is built for and that world is built for. I understand a lot of people say you're saying realm, it's not a realm. That's fine, it is a realm. But we will call them worlds because these are worlds on here. A world and a realm's the same thing. A realm's a world. A world's a realm. They're the same thing. So this is the world system. If it's got a gold star, you need to pay members or you need to buy yourself some bonds and get yourself a membership with that. Truly, really, honestly, get yourself some bonds. That way you can go and sell some stuff and you get yourself some starting cash rather than spending. Let's say the first 5 days on RuneScape as a level 3 are painful without no money, because you don't need the money to go through it either. You really don't, but it's a little bit painful because you've got to go through with nothing and you've got to go and collect everything and you feel like everybody else is rich, because the game is a massive cash sink. The game is a massive cash economy. This economy is brutal. This economy is straight out hard. This economy is to be represented as a real economy. This game is supposed to be as close to a one-to-one game as we can make. So this is a really hard game. So when you're the first 5 days and you're a low level, like, it's not that you don't know what to do, because really and truly you can go and do anything. You will just get yourself there and start doing stuff. But when you're doing it with no money and you walk into the Grand Exchange, it's the main area of where people would sit and trade. It's the only area where people sit and trade with the Grand Exchange or the online auction house. Grand Exchange means auction house, and the auction house means the Grand Exchange. That's what the Grand Exchange is. The Grand Exchange is an auction house, and a lot of people gather around there. So these are the worlds. I'm going to scroll through them. All these worlds are loggable. All these worlds you can log into. As you can see, most of these worlds at least have 100 people on, 800 people, 900, 700, 1000, etc, etc, and there's about 34,000 people spread between all these worlds, so the map becomes infinitely larger by the X amount of worlds. The gold star means that there's no that means that there's no players, because there's no players down there, but the gold star itself means it's a members world, which means you have to pay to play here. And when you're in a members world, you get the members items and you get more skills. All the skills are there when you're free. If it's a silver, you're free. You only get a certain amount of skills. You can take all them skills to 99, but you also only have a certain amount of gear, maybe up to rune, because this gear, it's the only gear you can use for free. If you're not too sure about spending money, there's no problem with starting. When you start, there's no problem being free to play. Go and do some quests on free to play. Go and kill some J-Ogres. Go and get a bit of money. Go and get your range up. Do stuff like that. Kill cows, get leather. Crafting's fine. Kill cows and sell cow hides. Last time I checked was a valuable money maker for low levels, just to go down to the cows, stay at the cows for an hour, raise your levels, buy yourself some new gear, feel cool because you bought yourself some new gear, see yourself physical progress and see that you've spent an hour and you're still not too far into the game. So it's a quite slow paced game. It's one of them games that you really do need to put time into. And I think this is about the only game. There are a few games out there, but I think this is about the only game that I appreciate, that I've been playing for 15 years, that I appreciate to come back, and it's still got the same standards, it's still got the same markets, and it's still got the same viable community and good community depending where you are. Now I've been talking a lot. But let's just go through it a bit more. There's a whole massive diverse music section. These musics down here, all this music section is unlockable. Everything's locked at the start, you have to unlock it. This is a whole music section, all the music's brilliant on this game, all the music's actually relaxing and calming. It's quite old fashioned, medieval theme, tavern music, quite a sense. Really, really good. The settings, I'm going to leave that, I'm not going to really talk about them, but if you do want to sit here and fiddle around to learn what you can do, it's not graphic settings, it's UI settings, it's how the UI works with you, and what benefits the UI can do. We're going to pop this on actually, I've just been PvPing, we log out when we die, when we go PvPing, so we don't lose too much. I don't like to go again and again, first death, log out, so if I go down to PvP and I get one band, and then I've got to log out and go somewhere else rather than lose my money. But let's tick this so we don't misclick. This means we can run around in the wilderness. The wilderness itself is a dangerous place. The wilderness is where the PvP happens with other players. And I'll explain this mechanic to you in a minute. Once you're in the wilderness, we're technically in the wilderness, but we're in a safe area. We're at the bank area. Sea Rock Enclave is where we're at. While we're here, when we run around, I'm in the wilderness, people can attack me depending on their level and depending where I stand in the wilderness. The further I go into it, the more higher levels that can attack me, and they're all players that can attack me. And the amount of time a player's logged on that's maybe about 10 or 20 levels higher than me but still a pure, will literally spaz out, will literally have a absolute amazing little incognition about how they're gonna turn around and leave my body on the floor but absolutely bank, even if I've not got nothing. So they'll just log in, jump on you and start killing you regardless. And because it's a nice social game, if you ask someone like off or get off me, a lot of people will, but sometimes they don't, generally they don't, when it's PvP. But it is a dangerous game out here in the wilderness, and this is the part that I like to explore. So this is a new setting as far as I'm aware. I haven't played this game for a year and a half. I logged out a year and a half because I had a few of my own self commitments that I had to go and follow, that I had to go and look into. I also got the internet taken off me and banned. I also got a lot of hackers on me. I've also got the army and the police on me. I've got quite a lot of people on me, including Freemasons, the Illuminati, and stuff like that, and myself, welcome as the occult as well. We've got all that on this as well. I don't sit there and search this. This will all sit and play on top. Just if anyone wants to be aware about it, that's the stuff that I have on me daily, and that's the stuff that watches. So yeah, hi to all these people that are watching me. Hello, have a good day. We're going to go down to Calisto. Hopefully there's no funny business with the servers. The RuneScape servers sometimes can go down, but I haven't experienced this in the last 18 days unless I went to a PvP world. So it looks like good news for the servers. As a person that's logged in for a long time, there ain't nothing I can knock about this game really. This is the mobile app. This is the mobile app. There's quite a few things I can knock about this, but we're not gonna go there. We're not gonna mention it. But there are a few things that's a little bit bad about this mobile app, and a few things that I'd like to see improved. And like I said, I'm really happy to be here and playing RuneScape. I'm really happy to be here and be playing this game. So without a doubt, we might die because this is dangerous. But let's actually get moving. Let's go down to Calisto. So you want to be at Ferox Enclave, which you're going to want a ring for. Now, while we're here talking about rings, let's talk about how you can improve your gameplay. With your first couple of million, what you want to do is you want to learn how to get about the map a little bit faster rather than walking. The main things you need is to be able to get yourself to the auction house, because anything you want can be brought from the auction house. And unlike other auction houses, you don't have to look for an enlisted item. You've just got to look for an item and you try and buy it. And if someone else in the world has sold it, they don't have to be logged in. So at the quarter of a million, at least, if someone's put that item up there, We've got guidelines on how much these items are worth, but you can put whatever you want in and charge whatever you want and then wait however long you want. But the Grand Exchange, the auction house, is the main priority in this game to get anything to gear you up, anything that wants to help you through quests, so you don't have to go and look for it, so you don't have to go to the Wikipedia. You can just go and type it in on the Grand Exchange and collect it if you don't know where to get it from, which is perfect, which is really easy. It's quite nice and quite a luxury to be able to go to a working auction house and 9 out of 10 times get the item you want for the price recommended, or a little bit more or a little bit less, depending on how much you've got to wait. The first tip I would say is make sure you've got yourself some form of method to get down to the Rock, which is the main city. It's the main PvP city, the main free-to-play city, and it is one of the main members. It is the main point of the whole of RuneScape. Now, RuneScape itself, if you're interested in lore, is based in Gillenor. And also, if you like lore that much, there's a prayer system to the combat. Then people that said they want to get a little bit more talented or have a little bit more of a realm atmosphere to their game, when you're fighting, when you're not fighting, when you kill someone, there's interactions for them gods. For the gods, and the gods are followed pretty heavily on these games. The main gods, there's three main gods. You've got Guthix, you've got Saradomin, and you've got Zamorok. Between them, you can find out what they are yourself by explaining and seeing the game through quest lines, which are fantastic to go and indulge in. They're not that hard. And also, there are some features on this game through the settings where you can turn yourself and put Wikipedia on here, so you can click it and you can go and get the answer you need so you can continue with your map and your game. But the first thing I would say to improve your time and improve your ability to do anything in this game is make sure you can get to the Rock, and make sure you can get to the Rock pretty fast through teleport. So either have 25 magic, and keep the runes in your bank to teleport to the Rock if you're poor. Make sure you can buy some teleport tabs to the Rock. You could also get yourself some jewelry, the glory jewelry, the dragon jewelry, the purple jewelry. That jewelry, the ring and the amulets, the necklaces, will teleport you to a close area near the Rock. Now, if you want the glory, you're going to have to get 25 agility as well, so you can cut through the little shortcuts, because we have an agility system and we have a run system in this game. We also have a prayer system. So to do that, make sure you can get to the Rock pretty easily. Make sure you can get to the auction house pretty easily. Make sure there's a teleport there, because you ain't going to want to be on the other side of the map and not being able to get back all the way to the Rock just to buy an item. So that's key number one. Make sure you've got a teleport to the auction house. And rule number two is make sure you have a teleport to a bank. Now, let me tell you, there are two rings that I will appreciate as a bank ring for a low level, and that would be the Slayer ring. The Slayer ring's not that low level. The Slayer ring's got high requirements of doing Slayer, 75 crafting, and actually making them yourself. But it is the cheapest banking ring that you can buy, and the Slayer ring itself works at 30 wilderness. So just like the glory, just like the purple jewelry, them things, the dragonstone jewelry, just like them, they can sit there and help you teleport away when in the wilderness at level 30, just like the Slayer ring. The other ring is the Ring of Dueling. The Ring of Dueling can take you to Castle Wards, which is a bank. Really and truly though, you want to now use Ferox's Enclave, simply because you've got a prayer altar down here. You've got regeneration pools that you click, get full health from, no longer get poisoned, remove all your buffs, gain all your prayer, and gain all your run, so you get fully reset. The only thing it doesn't do is remove your skull, so it gives you every other feature. So this is the second ring that I would recommend, so you can teleport to either Castle Wards or Ferox's Clove Enclave. The Slayer ring is for later if you want to save money at high level, but this ring, the Ring of Dueling, is a main ring. Maybe put 10 of them in your bank and make sure you can walk to your bank. When you walk to your bank, for example, if you want to go down to the rock and you haven't got yourself any form of method to get there, the fastest thing you can do is go to Three Rocks Enclave and walk south. It's quite dangerous. Or you can go to the Dulu Arena and walk west with 10 coins in your pouch, and then north, and they're semi-easy ways to get there. But make sure you've got a ring to teleport to your bank. You want to be able to teleport to your bank, so when you're in an obscure location, or you've got to go to an obscure location without a bank, if you've got this ring on you and you forgot something, and you've got there and forgot something, rather than walking back, you can just teleport back down to your bank, take it all out, and then go back on your journey. So if you go on a journey around anywhere on this game and you're not sure where you're going, make sure you have some form of teleport back to the local city of the rock or back to a bank at least, and have them local teleports in your bank. So you can load all your teleports in your bank, but make sure you have a main item to get back to your bank. So I've been talking a lot. They're the two tips that I would totally give to a new player. Is make sure you've got yourself some form of teleport to a bank, maybe with rings. There are a few other teleports to a bank, but the best one at the moment that I can say are these Ring of Duelings. These Ring of Duelings can be made at a low level, and you can train multiple skills. If you get into the game and just want to make these rings and sell these rings for the first month or so, you'd make yourself a lot of money. So let's go down to Calisto. We've got to go down to 35 Wilderness. If you look at the bottom of the screen, you'll see the level 35. We're going down to 50, sorry. We've just landed at 35. That's how many levels above me can attack me. So anyone 35 levels above level 60 can attack me. So anyone being level 95 could attack me here. It's a pretty dangerous area. But we are on a pretty high leveled world for a level 60. So hopefully we're not going to get no damage. But this is the wilderness. These are the Obelisk. This is the teleport ring that I was talking about. I'm going to quickly open this map for you. This is the map. This is the small little area we're in. I believe that we're here, where it says cancel. That's where we are at the moment. We actually need to get ourselves. Let me just scroll out. I'll show you the length. We're this small little thing here, a really, really small little dot, and we've got to go all the way down to here, and there's only a teleport at that top right. But then we've got to go down to this fishing spot, because Calisto lives about here. So we've got to go and walk all the way over there. That's why I'm using these teleport obelisks. This is only a small area. This is a continent on the map. This is called the wilderness. That's the continent of Gillimore. That's one continent. As you can see, this is another continent, the Kingdom of Asgrinna, or however you say it, Kingdom of Missalin, Entrancha, Crandor, they're all continents. Now, as you can see, if you're lost, the whole map's here. The map will tell you absolutely everything. Everything is there. Walk over to it, inspect it, see if you can use it. It'll give you ambition and other things to do. It's a quite nice place to go and explore if you can. Now I can't zoom out anymore. Let me try and pinch this. That's as far as the map zooms out. So let me just quickly scour around it. Hopefully no one killed me. So this whole area, this whole black area is the PvP zone. This is the only area that's really, really dangerous when it comes down to losing all your stuff and people fighting you. This area is huge. That's where PvP happens. Now you can see down here, this is all safe. It's the same size as that PvP area. It's the exact same size. This is where the auction house is. The auction house is just... Oh. As you can see, it's a large game. There's no mounts in this game, but there are teleports. Everything else you have to walk around. But you see this area here. This is called the Grand Exchange. That's where you want to be as a new player. That's where you want to go and wander over to, so you can go down to the auction house. And as you get to the auction house, you can go and buy anything from this section. Absolute anything. And that's our global auction house. That is the equivalent to the auction house and the MMORPG that all your fellow guildies will gather around and the other people will gather around. That is the equivalent. And before we continue to get there, any new player in this game will start here in Lumbridge. You start literally there. That's where you start, that's where you log in when you first start. If you walk across the bridge and go north and follow it up, you can even go north however you want. Eventually you'll go into this little area. And once you go into this area, you want to look at your map, you want to go to the Grand Exchange. Good thing about this, Grand Exchange, press enter, and it will take you over to it. Just like, let's say, Ape Atoll. You don't have to search if you know what it's called. So on the quest, if it says something, like can't go to this area, you can search it on your map and see where it is. But let me just quickly scan over the map for anybody that's never played this. This is the whole west side of the area. The map's huge. All this to walk around, all this to explore. Let's go top to bottom. It's all that area. I've gone over it pretty fast, but it's not small. It's not small at all. And you'll realise it's not small at all. This area on the far right is this whole area here. This Mauritania is all locked behind a quest. The quest is actually a novice quest. It's called Priest in Peril. But to get here, you do one quest. You get a little bit of experience for your prayer, give you some prayer experience, and then you've got this whole new area to explore. And it's the same with other places. For example, the bottom of this desert, this whole area over here, the bottom end of this desert, to get into this small little booth, you need to do a quest. That small little booth is a quest. This is Tutorial Island. Can't get back to Tutorial Island, but this is where you very first start before you go to Lumbridge. You'll come here, and it will tell you how to play the game. It will read to you how to play the game. It will demonstrate to you everything you need to know to continue. Everything, all your skill comes from logging in on Tutorial Island. Your skill, your PvP intelligence, everything comes from that island when you start, because it tells you how to play. And it's one of the best tutorials when it comes down for a multiple amount of professions, because it will tell you about all the ones that are free and all the ones you can do while it's being free. And then everything else, there are tutors in the game, as you can see on this left hand side, tutors. Anything you don't know, you can literally click on this icon, it will flash on the map, and you can go over to one of these flashing icons, so you can get around pretty easily, you won't be lost. It's huge. You can talk to anyone, you can talk to anyone on this game. You can add many people. There's a lot of people that I've gone around and met. There's a few famous YouTubers that I've met, there's a few famous footballers I've met, a few famous comedians. I've met quite a lot of people on this game. I've even went and met a few famous pop stars, a few famous R&B hip hop stars. I've met quite a lot of people on this game in the last 15 years. So it's a really connected game, and the game is still alive. The game is still thriving. The game is still got a huge community. So eventually we're going to get down to this Calisto, because a lot of people are starting to believe it's not real. A lot of people have forgot what gear I take. But really and truly, this is my first video, so there needs to be more than just simply go down to Calisto and kill it. Because that is the basic concept of this video, to go down to Calisto and just kill it. Calisto, for them people that don't know and have been wondering what Calisto is a really furry, fuzzy bear. Calisto is one of the cutest bosses I've ever seen on any game. So, while coming to fight Calisto, this is the area that you want to get to from your teleports. It took us a while. I've had a lot of things to talk about. There's a lot of stuff that I enjoy about this game. And like I said, after 15 years, I feel to talk about this is quite fantastic. So we need to be at level 50. We'll open the map really quickly for you. We'll look at all that Slurpop and stuff like that, and we'll start sitting here and buying myself some more entertaining food and some more better food and stuff like that. I'll promise you I'll go around and eat better for that, and I'll drink better. But we need to turn up at this little teleport pad, and we want to go through this small little gate. Anyone that doesn't know how to read a map, any entrance is marked by a gate, which is red on a white line. Any fence is a white line. Anything, any fence or wall is a white line. Anything you can walk through is a red line. Anything that wants to go underground is a dungeon icon. And also, I'm pretty sure, as you can see, that's another example. That's a doorway going into that enclosure with the red line. There's quite a lot to it. That's a whole building. There's a doorway going into that building, etc., etc. And the doorways are marked on the map. I'm trying to look for a ladder really quickly, but I believe these ladders are still marked by the dungeon mark. Anything going up and down looks like it's marked by a ladder. Let me quickly see if we can see any exception. No, can't see any exception. Also, we have holiday events. We have holiday events every single Easter, every single Christmas, every single Halloween, Thanksgiving. They have holiday events. We will have holiday events. Anyone that's into RuneScape gets a holiday event and free gifts for taking part in the community. So we want to come down to level 50 wilderness. We are down at level 50 wilderness, and we want to go and make our way down to Calisto. At the moment, it looks like it's frozen. At the moment, it looks like we're going to have to log out and log back in. It's not a problem for us. Been talking about quite a lot of things, so let's just let it log out. Let's just wait. I'm going to come back in a second when it's logged in. We're back. Sorry for any camera shift. Sorry for anything being ripped off. We did just get disconnected. It's probably my connection. It's probably nothing else apart from my connection. The first thing I want to do when you log back in, if you log out, it might log you into a different world. So another simple tip is when you log out, check what world you're on and make sure you're in the right world. We are in the right world. It gave us the same world. But if you have to reload the application, make sure you're in the correct world, so you're not in the wrong world. We are lagging a little bit, so it seems like there is a little bit less of faith in this opportunity. But basically, you want to get to level 50 wilderness from that teleport pad, and you want to go southeast. Is it southeast? It's southeast. You want to go southeast through that small little gate, not making it complicated. Just go east or go south and east, and you'll walk into this gate. You want to walk around, you want to go down a little bit. Let me just move my camera back. Thank you very much for them mistakes. We're going to keep them in. We're lagging out. I don't really want to go around, continue this trip after all this speaking. Unfortunately, this is why content is going to be me talking rather than me showing you content, because my content and quality of content is generally disrupted and ruined by these other people, because they just can't let me have a good time, they can't let me have a good video, they can't let me promote myself. And also, if you've enjoyed this video, comment, like and share. Remember, I'm a person too, I've got to make a living, and I'm new to the whole of YouTube, so I'm looking for some community stuff, vibes and feels. But let's go and do it. So we get down to this situation here. I want to make sure that we've got our dragon bow on. Really and truly, I want to make sure I'm not lagging, but really and truly, we're just going to continue. If I die, I die. If I die, I might not even do YouTube again. I might not even put a video out. But if I die, I ain't continuing, because the quality of the video beforehand into the quality of me just being attacked and logged out, that's what that is. It's a DDoS attack. Unfortunately, this game has a lot of people in the background, like the moderating team and the Jaggets team, can look at your screens and see what you're doing. And unfortunately, they turn around and target people. They turn around and make sure people generally have a negative time. I don't know why they do it. I really don't. But I will be targeted, and they do make sure that I have a negative time. And it does generally impact on the general performance of everything that you play. I can still get through it. It still don't bother me. It's just quality like this. After 45 minutes, we're finally at Calisto, and they've turned around and decided to make me lag. So it's a hilarious joke for them. They're going to sit there and be all like, oh, we're all one up, we're all top, we're all good, we're all this. I'm just going to say the sad, I'm just going to say the pathetic, I'm just going to say it's absolutely like a couple stars or something, you know what I'm saying, couple stars and all that, just to just sit there and put profanity out of the picture, because we haven't actually came here or swore once since I've been playing this game. Here's a person, let's see if this person will attack me. He's just logged in and logged out. Quite dangerous. I'm generally standing here looking for the server to be better, so we can go and attack it. It doesn't look too good, but it looks doable. So we've got four player. This is the main concept of this video. I've got really carried away. I really enjoy this game. This game to me is absolutely fantastic to play. It's a really good engaging game. But when we come here, what you want to do is you want to eat an anglerfish. As you can see, my health's just gone up to 90. You want to eat an anti-poison to make sure you can't be attacked by these poison spiders. And you want to run down west at the bottom of this lava pit at 41 wilderness. And you want to look for this big bear. He's level 46. They're trying to get me to die. I've just ran in and I've literally been loaded up, so they're probably going to let me hit it and they're probably going to disconnect me. That's Calisto. We hit it and we run off. When we run off, we want to run behind this this tree stump here. We want to run back to this first tree stump until we see Calisto. Let's talk to the genie and take the genie lamp. And then once Calisto appears behind this tree, you want to run down at this pile, and then you want to run straight, and nothing else but straight. Make sure he don't hit you, he might hit you, and we want to wait here, and then once it's trapped in that little bit there, we can run to the side and hide. It might unload itself, no. And then we hide behind this spot, and that's the safe spot set up, and now we can just go in and attack. It seems hard for people. The main concept in that, first of all, is we've got to make sure that we always range pot as soon as you start. Put your range pot up. I'll show you what a potion does right now. If you can see the range skills, we have 92 out of 80, which means my level is 80, but because we've taken a potion, we get a 92 effect. That will degrade, that will slowly degrade in time. I'll show you that as we go along. Let me just take my lamp. This lamp itself, they said, what do you need? I said, I need to do myself agility, because level 40 to 50 agility requires the place called Canis, the very first place I was on about you could unlock from Priest in Peril. We need to do Priest in Peril. For me to do Priest in Peril, my level will go up, my prayer will go up. So I've stayed away from it. Really and truly, if you're going to play this game and you don't want to be a pure, and you want to be a boss, and you want to be a tank, and you want to be all in armor, which is what the majority of people do on this game, the average people, then that's brilliant. Go and do Priest in Peril, which means from 40 to 50 agility, you can turn around and you can level up at Canifis area. But I can't do that because I've not done Priest in Peril. So at the moment, I'm just lamping agility while doing everything else, because I don't want to run the Varrock course again. I don't want to run it another double time to what I had to do it. I used to like agility, but I've done enough agility as it is. Let's talk about some upsides. I'm pretty sure Calisto hit me. Calisto did hit me, in fact. But I'm still 84 health. That is the effect of having an anglerfish. The anglerfish took me from 75 to 90. So if Calisto, because I haven't got prayer on, if Calisto turned around and hit me for a 60, then I wouldn't have died. And I can be hit, I can eat up and be hit like a 50. I can still get comboed out. I have been comboed out a few times by Calisto, but I can survive two hits from Calisto almost guaranteed, with like a 95% chance of surviving, even if it's on one health. So I can get hit once or twice during this lore, simply because I've eaten myself an anglerfish and I don't have to eat another item in between that. So that's the first thing. The reason we bought a swordfish are for these bolts here. These Ruby Bolts E has an effect that once it hits with its enchantment effect, these bolts are enchanted. You can get Ruby Bolts, you can get Adamant Bolts, which is what the Ruby Bolts tip with. It's an adamant bolt tipped with rubies and then enchanted by magic. You can just buy them on the Grand Exchange, go and buy them at the auction house. You can get them from there. It's pretty expensive for a lower level. For the higher levels, it's relatively cheap. 250 gold pieces per one. That effect is why we turned around and brought Swordfish. As you can see, the Anglerfish and the effect turning off while the Anglerfish was on has left me at max HP, and that's the HP that we started at. So we're not negative at the moment. We haven't lost out any health. But we lose health every time we do hits with the enchantment. The enchantment hits 20% or up to 20% of Calisto's health or the enemy's health. If you're fighting players, it will only take up to a maximum of 20. An extra 20, that is. When it comes down to Calisto, I think I've maxed out at 51. I think that's my max at the moment. And because of these bolts, killing Calisto isn't too hard, isn't too long. I've made this thing look easy. I've had problems with this lore. I've had problems setting this thing up. The main thing is to run past that branch, run past the rocks. Once you run just one square past the rocks, don't run any further, just run in a straight line and literally run behind this bone pile. And once you're behind the bone pile, go and walk in this diagonal square here. Once Calisto's gone past this small little branch over there, and I'm trying to sit here and explain to you everything that would happen and everything you'd see, but the key concept is hit Calisto, run to that first tree, wait till you see him, and run around the rocks and down, and just run all the way down to this small little bone pile. Don't really matter too much. Once Calisto gets a little bit close, just hop yourself over to the right and he'll be put in a safe spot. But this is generally Calisto. It would take me roughly about 150 bolts on average. This is a sped up kill. It's quite fast. I'm actually supposed to pot here, so we are going to pot. And then also, the reason that I say bring a dark bow is simply because we can turn around and we can spec just to make sure we get a little bit extra damage on, because Calisto does turn around and heal itself. I'm only level 60. Calisto is a 470 bear. It gives a small pet, which is what I want. That's the only reason I'm here. Apparently, I've got to do anywhere up to 1 to 2,000 kills. So I'm going to go down to 2,000 kills if I have to. But I want a small mini Calisto pet. I want a small mini bear on my account. So that's what we're trying to do. And the concept's pretty easy. As you can see, you can turn around and AFK. As soon as you've got this lore set up, you don't have to do much. You don't have to pay too much attention. The only thing you've got to pay attention to are these PvPers. Fortunately for my situation, being only level 60, I can only be attacked by level 97s or lower. So anyone that's level 97 and below, you could come down here and start a fight with me. The majority of people that come up here in armor, I'd have to run off. There's no chance that I'm going to hit you up. In fact, I probably would, actually, with me having a setup for Calisto, I'd probably hit you pretty high at the moment, and I've got a combo weapon. But for you people that are level 97, could come down here and attack me. With me being level 60, and with me being in a 1250 skill total level world, the chance of a level 70, level 80 that's built as a pure, and a pure as an account with one defense, or a lower defense level, or lower stats on purpose, is what a pure is. If a pure came around here with boosted up attack stats and no defense stats, and tried to dominate me for the 10 or 11 levels that they have in combat, which is probably a heavily 150 other levels in the combat skill that they get on top of me, it seems a bit like an unfair fight, and people would just turn up at the Calisto spot and kill me. Fortunately for me, people that make them accounts don't spend time doing all the other professions, because they normally have a main account. So I'm in this world to hopefully avoid being attacked by them people. And so far, so good, it has avoided being attacked. Calisto is a bit of hit and miss with the hit rate. I recommend just bringing the Swordfish to neglect the bolt enchant. As we hit the 20% of its health, we also take 10% off our health. So we take about 7 damage, depending on how much damage we do every time we use a bolt enchant. So we're just going to eat swordfish to keep it cheaper, seeing as we're not too bothered about being PvP around here. We're not too bothered about being attacked by people in PvP down here at all. We're not that bothered. As you can see though, this is the why I recommend the dark bow. The dark bow is the third, I think the third strongest bow that you can buy. It's pretty cheap. It's about 600,000, which is super cheap in this game when you look at the end game. The majority of people that are level 126 will generally have about anywhere between 200 million to a couple billion just from leveling and collecting the skills and the resources and selling it. So 600,000 is pretty cheap to them. In fact, 600,000 to them is something they'll donate. And if you do walk around and if you are pretty friendly, people will generally give you a bit of money for helping them out and spending time, because a lot of people appreciate people's time on this game. It's a very wholesome game. It's a game where you've got to spend quite a lot of time. And in this time, for example, all I'm doing is talking. However, because I don't have to touch much, realistically, I don't have to do my special attacks. But because I don't have to touch much, I don't have to do these special attacks. I could just turn around and leave it. For example, what I'm planning to do is misclicked, that could have been it. That could have been one bang by Calisto at 64. Because I didn't have the right bow and arrow on. But I haven't really been doing much apart from talking. I haven't been doing much interactions. If you can see, I've eaten 2 food, and it's basically been attacking this boss for a long time, because it's quite a high level, got quite a lot of health. So because of that fact, I've got about anywhere between 3 minutes to 5 minutes off my own time to do anything else. So I could do editing, I could watch YouTube, I could just watch some movies, I could do some drawing, I could do some games design, I can make a song, I could do some writing. It's normally writing that I do. At the moment, I'm currently writing 8 books. I've got my first book written out. The first book is the world's longest book. It beats the world's longest book record. My first book's 2.4 million words long. It was 15,000 pages. It's gone down to 12,000 pages. It's at 9,500 pages, but it's still put 2.4 million words, so it's still the longest book. It is on Amazon to see. If you want to go and search my name, Brett Blatherwick at Amazon.com. Salutations to B, because that's me, got 2 of them. If you want to search my name and have a look at the Amazon book, you can do. Unfortunately, Amazon scuffed the version up. The upload's a little bit bad. It won't even spell my name correctly in that book at the moment. So you can go and have a look at the book if you want to go and get Kindle Unlimited. Kindle Unlimited should be the advertisement or sponsor for this video, because Kindle Unlimited is what I want to advertise my book on. So if anybody wants to go around and see my book, please go down to the Kindle Unlimited, get your Kindle app and search my name, or search A Fairy Tale. The link will be in the description. I'll put 2 links to them books. At the moment, it's not fully ready. At the moment, the book itself's fully ready and pristine. I've got the 12,000 word document saved, the 2.4 million word document. That's what I've been doing for the past 3 months. Been writing the world's longest book. Quite happy about my achievement. Let me quickly talk about the drops I've got. So we get a looting bag, which is brilliant, and we've just got ourselves 100. As I said, this bow's not that expensive. I've just killed that boss and I've got 181,000. The bow itself is only 600,000. So as you can see, the expense is on an average of getting 4 kills. It could pay for my bow. At the same time, I might get a lesser roll. But we got a pretty decent drop. I came here and I've made all my money back for my bolts. These are going to cost me... It cost me 110,000 gold for 400, and we've only used 55,000, so we've already made our money back, which is good. Back to this book before we go and kill one more, because we are set up for 2 kills. So I'm going to go and show you that we can sit here and look pretty cool killing 2 of these large bears, these nice cute fuzzy bears. You normally catch me sometimes spending 5 minutes staring at the Calisto beer and speaking my whole life story about it and asking it questions like who's cuter. And Calisto will sit there and certainly say himself. With my book, it will all be in the description. It's not 100% finished. As far as Amazon's upload to Kindle quality is, I haven't even got a laptop at the moment. I am actually playing on the Amazon Fire Tablet 7-inch. That's also going to be in the description. I'll put what I'm playing on in the description. I'll put my books down in the description as well, so you can have a look. If you want to laugh at something that's been put a lot of time in and been ruined, you can see my name has not been written down correctly on these books. And my name's written down on about every other 13 pages out of the 12,000. So my name's been written down in this book about 1,000 times in the world's longest book. And Amazon's upload scuffed it. So I've got to go and afford a laptop. As a person, I'm pretty poor. As a person, I live in poverty. As a person, I ain't even allowed to get a job. I had to sign my life to not having a job. They physically made me sign a piece of paper to say I'm not allowed to go and search for a job no more. I'm not allowed to have a job and I'm only 28. So I can't have a job. My money's limited and I like to play RuneScape. So this is what I'm doing. So let's go and set up this next Calisto kill. Let's hope we don't die. Because if we die, we lose an extra 181,000. But everything's going to be down in the description. I'll link you down to my books. Eventually, there's going to be 8 in total. So it'll be something to look out for. I do need to go and get a laptop. I need a laptop to sit there and actually sort it out. And to go through all this editing process of this book that it might need. It doesn't need editing actually. It just needs to be put in the correct format that the Kindle app will turn around and accept. Not quite sure why it hasn't accepted a full PDF document correctly. It's pretty shoddy to say it's a billionaire company. But I was depressed. I was upset about it. But we'll put it down at the bottom. So if you want to go around and see this book and download it or have a look. If you want to get involved in Kindle Unlimited and get some books out and get some reading out and get some intellectual stuff out, then feel free to. I'll pop my book down in the description. You can have a look at the mess that it is. But at the same time, it's quite fun to go through and look. And also, if you could help me out, if you could like, if you could share, if you could comment. But also, if you do go and get your free trial for the Kindle Unlimited, if you can download my book and spend an hour and a half scrolling through the book, you can physically pay me £30, or about $45 is what I'd earn if you spent a whole hour or an hour and a half just to race down to the bottom of my book. I would make some money from that. And I would actually be grateful that someone's gone through and made me that money. And that would make me the money. And while you're playing this game, you've got plenty of time to do something else. So if you ain't got nothing to do, pick up the Kindle book, do some reading, get Kindle Unlimited and scroll through it all. Especially my book. And that means you can physically pay me £30 or $45. You can physically pay me that from your actions of just scrolling through my book. So we'll put all that down in the description. The video's getting on quite long. We've been going for an hour and 8 minutes, which is already too long for a short video for someone to turn around and watch, especially when it comes down to a content or a creation thing in YouTube where not many people have too much time. So once again, I feel this video is going to get left out. I feel this video ain't going to go too far at the moment because it's so long. However, we're here for 2 packs, so let's go and get 2 packs. So we want to eat our anglerfish. Now you can see we're on 9 health. We want to eat our poison. And we want to run back down and go and find Calisto. Now Calisto himself, I've been sneaking quite a lot. I've been talking quite a lot rather than going and doing it. But Calisto should spawn pretty fast. So let's hit him. As soon as we hit him, run off. And we're going to do it one more time. So I'll run behind this bench here, the very last tree. I'll run behind it and stand behind it. And we're going to wait for Calisto to appear. There we are. He's appeared. Now he's appeared. We're going to wait for him to touch the tree. He touches the tree. We're going to run down this rock and we're going to run straight. And then we're going to run past here. We're going to wait until we can see him. When it comes in close like that, now it's gone across, we can go across. You see that? It's gone across, so we can go across, and now it's trapped. and then we can just pull this out and start attacking them again. Wanna get the second prayer pot, start praying. Now, as you can see, there ain't really no need for taking two anti-poisons. However, if you're not very good at the law, I consider myself not to be very good at the law. You've just seen two decent law attempts in this video, but really and truly, normally I struggle. Really and truly, there are a few fights with Calisto that I haven't needed to have, and Calisto I turned around and banged me out quite a few times that we didn't need to go through. This one turned out pretty good. This one turned out quite quality, which I'm happy with. But yeah, while I'm talking about my books, while I'm talking about the Kindle Unlimited, if you've got a game like this, you can actually generally have this game on the side, and you can still run a business, you can still run your corporation, you can still run your ambitions and your hobbies and interests at the side of this game. You can sit here and play this game, and at the side of it, you can put your hobbies and interest into it while playing the game as well, which makes it quite enjoyable, which makes it an easy game to multitask on. There's nothing wrong with not doing anything else and just playing the game either. That's kind of what I have to do. I would show you the device that I'm writing on. I've actually got a BlackBerry Q10, a £15 phone, a $25 phone, the BlackBerry Q10, a pretty old phone. But because it's got a keyboard and it's cheap, that's what I write all my stories on. That's what I've been writing on. That's what I've wrote the world's longest book on. I've written it on a BlackBerry Q10. Let me just range potion. We just hit 90 on our range, so we're gonna range potion just to make sure we do bigger hits. But yeah, this game is a very good game to be spending time. This game is a very good reward system. As you can see, I've managed to spend a good hour and 20 minutes by the end of this, maybe 90 minutes by the end of this, I doubt it. But I've managed to spend a good hour and a half talking about this, and the thing is, I haven't even talked about this game the whole way through, and that's just part of this game, because the game's so long, some people find themselves to do other things. You can start looking at Netflix, you can start looking at music, you can start looking at the news, you can start looking at videos of interest or the television of interest. You can do them things while also playing this game. You can go and study while playing this game. In fact, this game is recommended for students. If a student wants to go around and have some form of social life while studying, this game's perfect. This game, they can sit down and do all these longer tasks that don't seem too excessive or too dangerous, like relaxing fishing, like cooking, like chopping trees, like mining. Some relaxing activities that take about 3 or 4 minutes. And in them 3 or 4 minutes, you can scour the internet, you can read your books, you can study. And also, you don't feel alone, because all these other people that are connected, these 34,000 other people online. Now, I've gone in a really obscure place, and not many people come to the wilderness, because not a lot of people like to risk. This is a gambling game when it comes down to this area, because I am risking everything in my bag, apart from 3 items. So everything that's in my bag at the moment, all my wealth in my bag. In fact, let me show you what I mean. You can go to your little player mark called worn equipment, and on your worn equipment, you can go and view items kept on death. Now, if I die, I will lose 236,000 gold just from fighting in this area. I can die to that boss and lose all that gold. But I can come back and I can pick it all up, because we have a gravestone mechanic. Because an enemy, an NPC, has killed me. A non-player enemy has killed me. So I can go back to where I died and pick up all my stuff. I can also go back and talk to the Grim Reaper in Felox Enclave, and I can pay money to give me my stuff back, rather than going back to where I died, just in case you forgot where you've died. You can go and talk to the Grim Reaper, and he will still give you all your items back. However, in this area, if a player logged in and killed me, my items won't be retrievable back from the graveyard or back from death, and all my coins that would be worth in items would be lost. just in my bag. Everything in my bank account is protected, but everything on me, including my armour I'm wearing, including my ammunition that I'm using, including the drops and the rewards I picked up from the kill, will be at a loss, will be at a risk if you're in this area. It's only in the wilderness area that this happens. If you're not in the wilderness area, you can pick up your items back and you can go to death. And your items are 9 out of 10 times almost always retrievable, unless you end up in a small quest situation where you can't go back to that area or something. However, if you die, it's normally a boss encounter, which means you can normally go back to that encounter and collect your gear. But I've seen a few situations that I can't give you demonstrations of or examples of, where people have lost their gear from dying in a quest boss room, and then they've got to go back in and the whole encounter is set up again and they can't pick up the gear because it's a new instance. There's a few similar things like that, but 9 out of 10 times, genuinely, this is a really, really relaxing game. I'm planning to come down to Calisto, get my 2,000 Calisto kills, and while I'm attacking Calisto, I'm going to do my press up, I'm going to do my kills, I'm going to put a gym up, I'm going to sit here and get fit, and I'm going to work on my health in my own house and in my own space, and maybe even get a boxing bag back in so I can do that stuff while this does this AFK league. That's what I'm planning to do, they're my plan. So this is the second kill. Altogether, we got about 200,000 gold from that, which is a good result. We spent ourselves 1,010, so we got ourselves 90,000 from two kills, and we got two kills up. We're on 11 kills, we're only on 11 kills. So once we've killed it, I've rushed off, my characters ran off and gone pretty fast and zoomed out. That's how the majority of people act. Once they're done, they run off. Now, the easiest way to get back to where you need to get back to a bank, when you're in PvP, when you're in the wilderness, is I have to run down to level 30 to teleport out. And this is what I'm talking about the teleporting levels. This ring down here, I'd have to run down to level 20 to teleport. This amulet here, I have to run down to level 30 to teleport, which means this is a better amulet when you're deeper in the wilderness, because you've only got to run 10 levels less before you can disappear, unless someone's made sure that you can't teleport with magic, which is a thing. But we want to walk down to level 30, you want to teleport out. Normally I've got my Slayer ring, however when I'm walking around with a setup that needs a little bit more inventory space just in case we get jumped, I will use a glory instead. We'll go down to our bank. As you can see, our bank is pretty closed. Our bank is just here. We can go here and we can just pop it in our bank. We're not that rich. We've got 6.6 million. All that money was made through PvP, and maybe about 600k was made from the 11 kills at Calisto. That's all that I've done at the moment. I've had quite a few deaths. I've died quite a lot. It's all hack game in here. There's a lot of stuff like these barrettes and stuff. A pretty good hack game with pretty decent inventory for them hack games. I'm going to quickly make it look a little bit better, a little bit neater, a little bit nicer. Bank management is a good thing. However, to play good, you don't need bank management, because now they've put this feature in where you can click here, you can search, and for example, anything red, red, there's everything red. Show me everything red in the bank. There you are. Everything red, including a red berry pie. It's got a nice search feature, so it doesn't really matter where things are. However, if for example you're skilling, you're gonna want things next to each other. Gonna show you the whole bank. Pretty poor, pretty trash. Not too bad, not too shabby for my level. Decent. So the last thing I'm gonna do before I say bye is I'm gonna walk you over to the auction house. I'm gonna show you the auction house. I'm gonna sell some stuff. Gonna sell some stuff at the auction house, and then we're gonna end up back where we started at Ferox Enclave. I haven't read it properly, or I have read it properly about 12 or 14 or 16 some times, or maybe 100 times, but it still hasn't sank in as of just yet. But I'm pretty sure it's Ferox Enclave is where we need to go back to after, so we can restart the Calisto grind, and then I'll start on my Calisto grind. So this is the exchange. Now, we'll do the exchange. I'll show you how the exchange works. So we come down here. the very first time you come down to the exchange, you need to speak to this gentleman here. You need to talk to the tutor before you can use it. So you'll come down and it will tell you this. If you go and use it, it will say talk to this person. So just make sure you talk to him. Once you talk to him, you have your auction house, which is the exchange. The grand exchange clerk is the equivalent to the auction house master. This is the auction house. You have a sell offer, you have a buy offer. So the sell offer works like this. You click the sell, you can click on the items that you've got, and it'll give you your recommended price, and that item will probably sell for that price if you're willing to wait. Now I ain't willing to wait, so I'll sit here and say I'll sell it one lower. Red dehys are really expensive, so I could probably sell it one higher and go do some bossing. But just for this demonstration of this video, I'm going to show you just a sell and how it works. So we put our offer of what we want for our item, and I don't have to wait for no one to go and look for it or enlist it, because someone's already got the item on order. Someone's already came to it and said, I want this item, and they've brought out X amount, and then the computer said, no, you've brought too many, or no, there ain't no more being put on for that low price, so you're going to have to wait until someone goes and puts it on. I popped it on, and it's brought pretty fast at a reasonable price. And that's how the auction house works. If you're selling an item, I'm going to just show that one more time. I ain't going to sell an item, but you click on it. Here's the bow and how much it's worth. At the moment, that is 600k. That bow gets retrieved quite a lot from people that die. A bow like this is a PvP weapon, which means then people that go PvPing and buy it for 570,000 because they need it just like that, have to pay 600k the next time. So it's definitely a 600k weapon. But that's how it works. You click on sell, and then you click on your item in your bag, and it will load it all in, and you can sit here and say, I want to sell two. It will sit there and say, you can't sell two because you haven't got two in your bag. And then I can say, well, I wanted to sell two because I want 1.2 million. I can go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. I want that much for my bow because I thought I had two. I can click confirm. It will list it down there, and as you can see, it's not sold because the auction house have gone, you've got a dark bow on the auction house on the grand exchange, and you want 1.2 million for it. No one's came to it and said, I want to pay 1.2 million when they've been advertised the price at 560k. That's why people pay 600,000 for this bow, because it's been advertised at 560,000 by the game. No one's going to come and pay that price. People will pray that eventually someone comes down and says, look, I've been trying to buy one of these bows. And a sale like this, a 1.2 million sale like this, will probably happen if it's like, let's say 5 o'clock in the morning somewhere, and someone really needs one of these bows, and they've been waiting 45 minutes and they still can't get one. So they've gone, you know what, I'm putting 10 million in and I'm taking it for whatever price. And then next thing you know, they get one for 1.2 million. That's how you make a sale like that. But let's take that back out. You just cancel it. Your item's fully returned. You don't get charged anything. Not while you upload it. You only get charged once you sell stuff. Now, if I want to buy something, you click on the buy. You have literally a typing box, and you can type whatever you want. So anything red. This is every single item that's red in the game. These items are all red, and you can go through, find what you need, look for what you need. Let me just go around and buy. Let me go and buy some ruby bolts. Let me buy something that I need, and I'll represent a sale for you, and I'll buy it at one maximum as well. So that's how much it's gonna cost me to go for another two kills, because at the moment I have that many bolts, which means I don't need to buy that many. Let's just buy 300 and save ourselves some money, because we've already got that. And then at the moment, these bolts are quite traded, and I'm willing to pay 500 per bolt. That's as high as I'm willing to ever pay for these bolts in my whole lifetime. But it will give me a nice chunk of change back. It says, look, you gave us too much money, That's the good thing about this auction house. You gave us too much money for a total price of 75,000. So it's still a little bit more than it was advertised at, which is why I was only going to go one or two notches over. But if you put too many on, it would, like for example, with the other bow, I put excessive amount of money on just to get the sale for whatever they cost. That's the highest someone's ever put them on the market, so that's the price I get them for. If someone wanted to put them on there for 500 coins, they would get a sale tomorrow for 500 coins because I'll come here and put 500 coins into them because it's a nice, easy round number, and realistically, 500 coins for one of them shouldn't be no. So, when you buy too much, you get your items, and it says to you, look, you gave us way too much, you offered us way too much, so you don't have to worry too much about offering too much. It says, you've offered us too much, this is the maximum price someone's put one up for, so here you are, you take it off him, and this is all the money that we've not spent for you, and then you just get your money back, and there you are, and then we'll just gear up, and etc. So, I'm going to go back down to the enclave. We ain't going to do any more fighting. We're just going to end it off really in the next 2-3 minutes now. So let's teleport to Three Rocks Enclave where we started. And let me go and show any new player where to go if you die and you don't know where your items are. You have to come down to here if you've lost your items and you want them back and you haven't died by another player. Right, you would have to come down here if you don't know where to locate them. Now, you can teleport here. You can teleport here. Or from the auction house is here. This is a small little shortcut that requires 75 agility. If you've not got it, you're going to have to go out this gate. You have to run around here. And you just have to run up. But once you've ran round or you've cut through, you literally go north. You know what I mean? You come out here and you go north from this little bridge and you'll go down to the area where you can reclaim all your loot back. That's the only place you can reclaim all your loot back unless it's where you died from. And to get that, you go down this small little door which is just south of the altar. So there's a prayer altar here. Let me quickly, before we go down and see death and log out, this drinking pool of refreshment, which is, let's log in and make it a little bit more entertaining. I like looking at my character a bit zoomed in. These little things here are little pools of refreshment. As you can see now, I'm full run. I've got full run energy. And believe you me, I'm going to walk to the death graveyard. This is the speed it will make you walk if you haven't got any run left. When I've got run, it will speed us up. But when I haven't, it will make you walk. The game will make you walk everywhere. So let's go down here into that small little door south of that altar. And this is death. Hello, mortal. Have you came to retrieve something new, lost when you died? I like sitting here and reading that stuff in my head usually because I like to think death is a little bit sinister. And I like to think that he hasn't got a mouth or a mind because of his hood. So I think that he might just mumble to you instead. That's kind of how I feel death looks like and acts. It gives you a lot of options, not been down to death. Let's just ask him how it works. Let's explain to you how it works. How does this work? When you die, you often drop things you were carrying. In most cases, a gravestone appears near where you died. And your items can be retrieved at your gravestone, which I told you. However, gravestones do not last for long. So, okay, if your gravestone no longer lasts and you can get to your gravestone, when your gravestone collapses, your items come to him. Okay, so if you've got to wait then to get your items, maybe, I'm not sure, and I'm not going to test that, and I'm not going to sit there and guarantee you that. But if you haven't managed to go back to where your items are, and your small little gravestone sign says, oh, you've got 15 minutes to go and get your items, and you haven't got there in that 15 minutes, don't worry, you can come down to death and you can get your items back. So, if your gravestone collapses, your items come here to me, I can return them to you, though I charge a fee for my services. So he will sit there and charge me for my items back. Aside from that, if you bring me your unwanted possessions and sacrifice them into the coffer here, I'll count their value against any future fees I charge you. So, if I've got items that I don't want to sell, and I've got items, and I'm dying quite a bit, and I'm used to dying. I die a lot in this game. If you die a lot and you want to sit here and put money into something worth it, let's say maybe you're out there with about £1 million worth of a million dollars just to sit here and bring the divide in. A million GP worth of items, I've died, I can't go and pick them up. Oh no, like all my possessions and all my really good looking gear has gone. Then don't worry, you can come down here and you can pay death some money. So now I'm being taxed by death. Death wants some money from me as well, and death is gonna come round and charge me for collecting your crap from the floor. So he will charge you, and if you got items or items that you don't want, you can bring your items down here and put it into this system. So that million might be like 200,000 rather than a million, because you gave him a crap load of items that you've gone and collected instead. So you've gone to him and gone, well, I've gone around and collected some items, Death, so here you are, and now you need to give me my items back for free. It's generally what he's saying. So so do you need to retrieve something you lost when you died? I wonder what I've got in here. Choose a different looking gravestone. I've already brought my gravestone, which is good. I think that was 2,000. Yes, have you got anything for me? Another thing is, rather than pointing and clicking, you can press the space bar to go past stuff. This is everything that I've got. I've got all this stuff in here. The only thing that I really want at the moment is the hood. I got caught tapping my ear. I'm not sure what that's for, you know. I'm not sure what people brought from that or anything, but if you want to buy me some wisdom and say what you think about someone who touches the ear in this specific way, someone that acts and behaves like that, if you know the answer to it, comment below, let me know. So let me get all my myth arrows. We don't want no myth arrows. Ruby bolts. It's cost me nothing. I ain't had to pay for them. I ain't had to pay for that. And let me... So, yeah, you can come down here. All these things that I've even got the Slayer ring and stuff like that. So we come back down here and we collect all our items from Death. Now, the last few things while we're down here that I want to touch upon is we've got Death here. On this game, there's a few things I haven't explained yet. You've got the magic book. At the moment, the magic book looks pretty dull. We're going to filter it out. We're going to show you absolutely everything on this magic book. They're all your magic spells from the basic books. In this game, there are three magic books that switch between each ones. They have specific names. If you want to know what they are, play the game and find out. I'm pretty sure you'd prefer not to have spoilers if you're new. But you have a magic book system that is already attached to your character. So you don't have to worry about learning new spells. You just got to worry about getting to the level to cast that spell. You also have a prayer system. The prayer system works the same as spells, apart from once you click it, it doesn't indicate nothing unless you've got your overheads here. A few bits of prayers will turn around. Like you can see, they need 43, 37 to use them prayers. I haven't got them, but the average person would want them. If you're new to the game, protect from me, go and get your prayer up, get to 43, and then you can stand and attack anything and put the correct thing on. For example, protect from melee. No one's gonna cause any damage to you. It's 50% on players. 50% is what they say, but I've seen people still get maxed hit. But when you go and fight actual NPCs, for example, if I went to go and fight Calisto and I put protect from mage on and it used a magic attack, it would cause no damage because magic's on. But if it attacks me with a range attack and I've got mage on, it would still cause damage. So you've got prayers, which are good. They're also a thing to look into. You feel pretty cool the first time you get them. You have your combat. This is how you choose what you level up. For example, it tells you, say, range XP, and then also range XP and defense XP. And this changes for attack, strength and defense as well when you're doing melee. The same with mage. You have emotions. The emotions on these game are fantastic. I haven't got much. I have the shield emotion and I have the small bunny rabbit emotion. They're the two emotions that I really like. I've got the whole mindset emotions. give it a kiss, blow her a kiss and stuff like that. So we've got the emotions on here. You can sit here and dance. You can sit here and can jig, for example. Our dancing is more like, I haven't really seen any dancing like that. I'd like to see an R&B video with that kind of dancing, you know what I mean? That kind of stuff would be quite entertaining to watch, because I am quite nerdy like that. I am quite geeky like this. I do enjoy certain things like this. But only specific certain things like this now, because I've grown up and I've kind of made sure that I focus myself in a more focused mentality to a more stable amount of average things rather than random things. I picked like a lane and stayed in it, is essentially what they want to say. You also have clans and guilds. You have a clan, you have you get a chat channel, which ain't a clan. You can just join that person's chat channel. Anyone can put a chat channel up. Just do that through the settings. As you can say, join, set up, can make yourself a chat channel. Them chat channels, you can tell people to join and people will join your chat channel and they will talk to you real time on that chat channel. You can also go and get a clan. You can make yourself a guild. They call it a clan in here. Same thing, guild, clan, same thing. Go and set up your guild or your clan by getting 5 invitations, like the general MMO consensus, and then you can get yourself a clan. Call it whatever you want. I'm not sure on the clan features. It's been really unexplored. Quite a new thing to have a clan also than a chat channel, because your chat channel used to be your clan. Now you can go and get a proper clan. You can also get capes. I'm pretty sure you can also get vexillums and banners or whatever they're called for your clan. I'm assuming you call it a vexillum. I haven't edited my hand to see what it's called on this one. And then you can also go to an other person's clan. So you can be in a clan and you can join someone else's clan channel, just out of preference, just out of easily join in with everyone else, really. And then there's a grouping system down here. This grouping system, you come down here, say what you want to do, you can click on it, and you can start grouping. For example, let's say God Wars, click there, click join, it will suggest your world, click teleport, you'll teleport over, see if there's anybody over there. And it doesn't put you into a group, it just puts you into the area with the world. So it puts you in the correct area and the correct world, and the people will already be there, which is pretty good. You also have, let me just change this, I like to stay on the clan one because the two blue smiley faces look pretty cool. That's where I like to hang. You also have a friends list. My friends list is quite heavily packed. I do talk to quite a lot of these people. I talk to a lot of them on here. A lot of these people talk to me. In fact, this person right here, Booty Fucker, this guy here came around and gave me 5 million because when I was learning Calisto, again for my second kill, I bumped into him for my third kill and he asked me for some help. He said, oh, do you want to give me a bit of help? He's 124, not max, 124, probably got a few prayer levels or something. But I was down there with him and he said, oh, do you want to give me a little hand so I can make my kills a little bit faster? Gave him a hand. He's added me. He said, come and meet me at the auction house. Went down to the auction house and he said, oh, here you are, here's 5 million, and he gave me 5 million. Which is actually why I've got 6 million in my bank, because the other day I was doing some dicing. There was a couple gamble games, a couple dicing games. I won myself 2 million, ended up gambling 6 million in total, and left myself on like 1 million. And then today, this morning, someone came around and gave me, not today, but yesterday, someone came around and gave me 5 million. Which is great, because I always like to receive a gift. There's nothing more than walking around like a cute female, pretending to be yourself, keeping it as yourself and not trying to hit on anyone and people come in and being friendly to you because you're a female. I've seen it all on this game. Oh, here you are, here's 5 million, you've been nice to me, everything you've said to me has been nice to me, so here's 5 million. However, I've seen this situation happen dressed as a male and people looked at you going, what does this thug want to do with me, etc, etc. Really and truly, you need to see this as, that's my character, that's my female, right? That ain't anyone else's female. Let me get that straight with people. There has been a lot of negativity about people playing other genders rather than their own gender. My theory to this is, if I play the opposite gender, for example, if you're a female and you play a male, you will look at the game in a different way and you'll look at all the surroundings in the game. That's why you do it. Not for the smaller hitbox, not for people treating you any different. I simply play a female in a game, because as I play a female in a game, it will allow the male population to look at the rest of the game, rather than being antagonized by your character. Rather than living an oath into your character, I don't do that no more. In fact, I actually don't want to play games no more. I don't physically want to sit here no more. If that makes sense to anyone, like, I'll just be here and take part. Beforehand, I used to live with a lot of emotion for my character. In all these other games, I used to live for a lot of emotion for the scenery and for everything to come part of. I don't have that no more. I don't do that no more. I don't sit there and indulge off the quality no more. I don't sit there and and it's not because of this game or this graphics, because this game and graphics are actually really good quality. Really good shade cell quality. Brilliant quality. But I don't sit here and take everything from this screen no more. I don't sit here and take everything from this game no more. Which is quite interesting to how much quality and content that they've given to me. But I'll play the female so I can look at the scenery without trying. So I can look at everything else apart from my character. Really and truly and essentially, because I'm not female, right? So if you're female and you play a male character on games that maybe you haven't picked a male character, but they force you to play a male character, these people want to sit here and get shoutouts to America. Really and truly, I don't know none of you. Yeah, let me keep it really and truly. You really and truly, these Americans, I don't know any of you. Don't know none of them, right? Like, I'm over here, I like to sit here and make connections, I like to sit here and make links. Really and truly, that I'm that type of person. You gotta go and message me and say, look, do you wanna come over? And if you're coming over, you've gotta stay because you're poor. I can't afford a holiday down to America, really and truly. I go to America, I'm moving there. It's as simple as that. I've got a lot of people that are really friendly from America. I also have a lot of people from America that turn around and hate British people. Really and truly, I ain't got time for none of that hate. I ain't got time for none of that. So for this, like I said, I've got the anonymous group on me. I've got the Illuminati on me. I've got the police on me. And I have the Army Corps on me. I have all those lot on me. I also have the government watching me from the British government. And I have the American government on me, yeah? I'm not even lying. I'm not making none of this up. And now the Americans have shut up, right? But when it comes down to Aris Group, when it comes down to the internet, when it comes down to all that stuff, they won't promote me or anything. So it's down to you lot that want to watch this, to like, comment and share, and to sit there and give it some subs. Is there anything else I want to cover? This is the bond system. Basically, click the bond pouch, buy yourself 3 bonds to get yourself started. Perfect, good. The last two things I want to do. So, let's look at this quest system before we log off, and then we're going, right? This quest system, the first page has been improved. We never used to have this page. This page here is very informational. This page here is very beautiful. This page here is very well laid out, right? This page here is really good. It gives you your character name. It's basically like your character page without its items, right? Gives you your combat level. Gives you your total level. Gives you your total XP. Gives you how many quests you've completed out of how many quests there are. And it gives you how many achievements completed out of how many achievements there are. It also gives you combat tasks completed out of how many combat tasks there are. And it also gives you a collection log. So there's a lot of things to do. And you click on it all and it'll give you all its information. We're not going to do all of that too much. But if you click on the green, basically these tabs at the top, blue are for quests, yeah? Go through all your quests. Green are for the achievement diaries. And purple are for the crown favours. And these favours are a part of an area in the other side of the map. This is the kind of newer content. And this newer content can be done from the start. You can, if you're a low level and you want to go do something new, if you're low level and you played it before, if you're brand new, and you want to go and do the new stuff that the new cool kids are going to do that they've played for too long, this is probably the favourite thing for you guys to go and explore. Click on this purple one. Go and click this and go and find that. You'll probably have a lot of fun also. But yeah, thank you very much everyone for watching. I really like this game. I really enjoy making these videos. I really am into talking. I really am into just letting out anything that I feel, especially in this environment and the environment it gives me. It's absolutely beautiful. Shout out to that picture and that drawing. It's a really one of a kind. It's a pretty nice one. what I put Piety on. Shout out to them ascending masters, shout out to level 12 to 14, and shout out to myself and them people that got a lot of love. Have a good day, and make sure that you enjoy yourself, and don't let me affect you in your life too much when it comes down to your own daily basic life, because I'm aware that these people hacking me can be a pain. So take it gear and take it easy.